In 1968, it was the tallest apartment building in the world, and its design has inspired dozens of buildings across the world, like the Burj Khalifa in Dubai.
A lot of famous people live or have lived there.
Film actor Mickey Rooney did.
Did he? I know Goldie Hawn and Kurt Russell did.
Alice Cooper?
You see, I fit in so well. Shopping with Goldie, karaoke and golf with Alice. And do you know what the best part about Lake Point Tower is?
What?
There's a secret garden.
A secret garden?
Shh. Well, it's not secret if you live there, but there's this 2.5-acre park with a playground and a waterfall that has gorgeous views of the city and the lake. I tell you, folks, if you ever think of moving to Chicago, then Lake Point Tower is the place to be.
J Premier, we gon' have y'all see, come here. It's real hip hop music for the soul, y'all. Yeah, second. Yeah. The perseverance of a rebel, I drop heavier levels, it's unseen, heard. A king with words, can't knock the hustle, but I've seen street dreams deferred.
Smile.
Spots in my mind where the scene occurred. Some say I'm too deep, I'm in too deep to sleep. Through me, Muhammad will forever speak Greek. Brothers with handshakes on ghetto landscapes, where man is determined by how much a man makes. Cop cognacs and spit old raps for young cats with cigarettes in the air. Niggerish stay fair under the roof with me. That's untapped. Need to be in the rock race, but they grab my life. Ran so far from the streets that you can't come back. Just remember, don't let him on the back. We got that.
What famous buildings do you see? Which tower?
Glass, eight raps, I order fries. Inspiration when I write, I see my daughter's eyes. I'm the truth, across the table.
All right, you guys, we are in Streeter, which is one of the richest neighborhoods in Chicago. Streeter is right here to the right of us in this little York thing. It's a statue. He has a top hat on with a little dog.
More than money saved, I want to save children. Dealing with alcoholism and Afrocentricity. A complex man drawn off of simplicity. Reality is risking me. This industry can make you lose intensity. The common sense in me remembers the basement. I'm Morpheus and this hip-hop matrix exposing fake shit.
And you know,
it's rap, real,
and
so
fit. And you know, it's
rap, real, and black people. Some days I take the L to jail with the real world. Got on an 87, so I bought this little girl. She recited rhymes, I forgot where they was from in them. She was saying how she make brothers come. I stopped thinking how many souls hip hop has affected. How many dead folks this art resurrected. How many late.
Okay, Big Boss, it's time to play a game. It's time to play Celebrity Chicagoan. I'm going to give you some clues to the identity of a famous Chicagoan. All you have to do is try to work out who it is. Just shout out if you know the answer. Everyone on the big bus ready?
Ready. Go for it.
Then
I'm ready.
Celebrity Chicagoan. I was born in Hermosa, Chicago in 1901.
Don't know.
I took art classes at 18.
Banksy.
I'm going to ignore that. In the early 1920s, I moved to California and set up a film studio with my brother.
Sam Goldwyn.
In 1928, I created a cartoon character in a film. His first words on screen were, "Hot dogs! Hot dogs!"
Now I'm confused.
That character went on to be a worldwide star.
Felix the Cat.
They became the face of my worldwide entertainment.
Another big bus.
Mickey Mouse.
Yes. So, who is our celebrity Chicagoan?
It's gotta be...
The Peacock.
Walt Disney!
That's right! He was a pioneer, visionary, and cultural icon, and most importantly for today, our celebrity Chicagoan!
Yeah, we play, 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 play.
the University of Chicago.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Big bus approaching yet another iconic Chicago landmark. Take a look to the left. Check out the Gothic style, its amazing flying buttresses. Yet another exclusive as Chicago presents the Tribune Tower.
Nice intro.
Thanks.
In 1922, on the occasion of its 75th anniversary, the Chicago Tribune announced an international competition for a new downtown headquarters. The competition was to
build for Chicago the most beautiful building in the world. Winner will receive a prize of $50,000.
There were more than 260 entries from 23 countries, and the winners were
architects Raymond Hood and John Mead Howells of New York.
Their Gothic Revival Tower appealed to the newspaper's owner's sense of nostalgia, history, and moral purpose. In 2016, they began redeveloping the building into luxury residences.
Extra, extra! The glorious Tribune Tower will be forever remembered as a cathedral for journalism!
Was my retail alarm. That means we're heading on to the one and only, the fantastic, the wonderful, the magnificent, magnificent mile.
You just said magnificent, magnificent mile. Can you do that?
I don't know, can I?
Well, it's called the Magnificent Mile.
Sure is. That's official. They secured the trademark on the name in 2001, and in my humble opinion, it is magnificent.
So I guess it's okay for you to call it the Magnificent Magnificent Mile.
Get on with it!
Okay.
Okay.
So the Magnificent Mile stretches from the Chicago River to Oak Street, and over the years it's been transformed into one of the world's premier shopping districts. The shopping, dining, and hotels here are magnificent!
Don't start!
Now, the idea for building the avenue came from the 1909 Burnham Plan. It recommended that they got rid of all the trading posts and warehouses on Michigan Avenue and built a grand boulevard like the Champs-Élysées in Paris. Trey, the building of a beautiful boulevard. What do you know?
In order to give it that Champs-Élysées feel, they had to widen the street. So they moved all the buildings on the west side back 60 feet. They widened it right up to the water tower that you can see at the top of the street. It looks like it sticks out.
The opening of the Michigan Avenue Bridge started a building boom in the district. They wanted to draw shoppers and businesses from across the river. But like a lot of things, it all fell apart in 1929 with the Great Depression.
Then in 1947, Arthur Rubloff, a real estate developer, started a plan to revitalize the district. His plan involved new buildings and renovating the existing ones. It was Rubloff who came up with the name the Magnificent Mile. It was in the 1980s that it really started to become world-renowned as the place to
shop, dine, shop, stay at a great hotel, and then shop, then dine, and shop, dine, stay at another person.
So long away.
The Disney Store.
At the top of the Magnificent
in Chicago,
we have arguably one of the most loved Chicago landmarks, the historic Water Tower. Now, you could say it's a little over-designed, as it was built in 1869 to hide a 138-foot standpipe. Yeah, that's right. That incredible Gothic castle was built to hide Chicago's plumbing. So the standpipe was needed to equalize the pressure from across the street, as that's where the pumping house is. The Water Tower is also one of our most cherished landmarks because it survived the Great Fire of 1871. It's said that a German immigrant fireman, Frank Trautmann, covered the buildings with woolen blankets and discarded canvas sails and kept the covers soaked in lake water. After that, the tower came to symbolize Chicago's I Will spirit as Chicagoans began to rebuild the city. Today, it houses the City Art Gallery, and it's listed on the National Register of Historic Places. When Oscar Wilde visited the city, he said,
"It looks like a castellated monstrosity with pepper boxes stuck all over it."
So, not to everyone's taste. But apparently, he did think the pumping gear inside was
magnificent.
That's the old water tower. Or is this the water tower?
That's the water works. That's more machinery.
The water works.